Hello, this is electronics to the introduction to electronics lecture, that is EC251, and today we will start about the topic op-amp. Op-amp full form is operational amplifier. So this is the agenda: introduction, analysis of ideal op-amp, comparison of ideal and non-ideal, and non-ideal consideration. So we start with what is an operational amplifier or op-amp. Now this is the symbol of op-amp. We can see this is a triangular shape, and it has two input. The input one is, here we can see a positive symbol is given. This is actually called non-inverting terminal. That means whatever we give to the input, the same output terminal, there will be no change. And there is another input too. We can see here negative symbol is given, so that means it will be negative. So input 1 minus input 2, input 1 is positive, input 2 is negative. So input 1 minus input 2, this is Vd or difference voltage. It will be multiplied with the gain, that will come to Vo. We can see Vo equal to Gd into Vd. So gain into the differential input, that will be the output. And these two, that is the, we can adjust it, the output range we can adjust by giving particular potential to these two points. And another important characteristics is that it has very high input impedance. Input impedance is very high, and in the range of infinity it is very high. And output impedance in the range of zero, that means it is very very low. Output impedance very low, input impedance very high. Okay, first point is very high differential gain. So we can see here it is written, it is generally 10 to the power 5. So we can see it is a very large number. So whatever the difference we are having between input 1 and input 2, that will be multiplied by a very large number and it will go to output. High input impedance, output impedance is very low, provide voltage changes, that is amplitude and polarity. We know this non-inverting is inverting, so output will be according to what input terminal is connected. Used in oscillator, filter and instrumentation, this is the application. Accuracy, accumulate a very high gain by multiple stages. So if we take 2 or 3 continuous stage, it can have very high gain. Anyhow, one stage also gain is 10 to the power 5. So if we want more and more, we can take corresponding different stages. Okay, coming to the next, this is the IC format of op-amp. So this is DIP741 IC. So we can see this is the inverting input, this is the non-inverting input, and these two for adjustment. This is the output, this is the structure. And dual op-amp 1458, here we can have two op-amp in a single IC. Now single ended input is that another terminal is connected to ground. So we can see in the first diagram, this is connected to ground. So we have only a positive terminal to give him some input voltage, and this AC cell is like this. So as it is the positive terminal, same cell we will have in the output. So positive terminal is the source, negative terminal is ground. We have 0 degree phase change. If in this case the opposite, that is if we are having positive terminal in ground and negative terminal source, so as negative terminal, so we will have just the opposite, that means 180 degree phase change will be there. Now double-ended input, we can see both the terminal is connected to the positive and negative terminal of source, that means it is AC source. So its one terminal is connected to the positive terminal, its another terminal is connected to the negative terminal. So that means in between these two terminals our source is given. So as it is connected between these two terminals, so we are having no phase change, that is 0 degree phase shift change between V0 and VD. VD is this one, V0 is this one, and differential input is the difference between these two, and it is same shape is going to output. And this is another case, V1 and V2, two different voltage is given to positive and negative terminal. So we know that it will be V1 minus V2, it will be V1 minus V2, okay. So if we have V1 minus V2, so we can see that at this point V1 and V2 is having the same magnitude, and at this point also V1 and V2 has the same magnitude. So at this two point, our the output will be minimum, because output is V1 minus V2 multiplied by the gain. So we can see if we have to choose between in this two point, at B point we can see that this point is connected to maximum, this point is connected to maximum, which is not the case, because when both the input magnitude is same, the output will be minimum. So this cannot be done. And at the case of A, we can see the maximum at this point, we can see this is the point. So at this point we know this is this one and this is this one, so we have this much difference, so it will be multiplied. So the A is correct and the B is wrong in this case, because our the difference between the two signal, difference between the two signal is multiplied. So at which is this point, difference between the two signal is very less, both are same, it is almost zero. So at this point it cannot be highest. So A is correct, B is wrong. Now we are having distortion by adjusting these two terminal. Suppose this is given positive 5, this is given negative 5 voltage, so our output will be blocked between these two side, and this portion and this portion will be cut it. That means the output voltage never exceeds the DC voltage supply of the op amp. So this is to adjusting terminal. Giving appropriate voltage in this two terminal, we can give proper range of the output. Now common mode operation, common mode operation means we are giving the same input point to both of them. Okay. Now it is written same voltage source is applied at both terminals. So ideally two inputs are equally amplified. Output voltage is ideally zero due to differential voltage is zero. Practically a small output signal can still be measured. Like just we have seen in the previous case, when both input is almost same, okay, we can have a little bit voltage here, and here also we can have a little bit voltage. So practically the difference between two input, if it is zero, still little bit output is there. So this is the difference between practical and theoretical. So we can take a note from this. If we are having opposite input, so as opposite input means in between these two, so total the voltage is given as the difference between these two terminals, so it obviously will be highly amplified. And if we are giving common input to both the terminal, because if both the terminal is giving same input, that means their difference is zero, so output will be very less. Practically it will be very less. Ideally though it is zero, but it is not actually zero in practically it is a very less amount. So common inputs are slightly amplified, and from this we have the terminology common mode rejection. Now coming to common mode rejection ratio, CMRR. So we can have two things: differential voltage input, that is the difference between two terminals, that is inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal, and common voltage input is whatever the voltage is giving common to both the terminal. So half of them, that is V plus plus V minus. So same voltage we are giving, so half of it is the average. Now whatever output voltage we are having, it is GDVD, that is GD is differential gain and VD is differential voltage input, plus another term we are having, that is GCVC, that is common mode gain into common voltage input. Now common mode rejection ratio is the ratio of these two gain, that is GD by GC. So that means differential gain divided by common mode gain, which is generally called in this format 20 log base 10 GD by DC, and its unit is decibel. So in this case, because it is a ratio of two gain, if GD is very very greater than DC, so CMRR tends to be infinity and Vout is only GD VT. We don't have the DC term if DC term is very very less compared to GD. Now there is one example of CMRR. Two input output is given, Now in both the case, differential input and common input, that is the these two divided by two, that is the average, this is given, and difference is difference between these two to voltage. Now from first one, this is the expression, and the second data sheet, the numbers, we are having this expression. Now we are having two equation, two unknown, so we can solve it and we can have the value of GD and GC, and the ratio of that, if we take 20 log, so this is the 40 decibel, that is the CMRR value. Now coming to op amp properties, first one is infinite open loop gain. Open loop means the gain without feedback, so output is not anyhow connected to input, and this is equal to differential gain. Zero common mode gain, so if output is not connected to input, common mode gain is zero, and practically this time to this time is the gain. So we can see it is 20,000 to 2 lakh, 20,000 to 2 lakh times multiplication is there, so it's a very very high, that's why it's written, it is equal to differential gain and common mode gain is 0. Infinite input impedance, input current is 0 ampere because it has very high impedance, so current cannot pass. So for high grade op amp, it is tera ohm, this is the range, and milliampere input current. In low grade op amp, in a high grade op amp, current is almost zero, and we can see very very high input impedance in case of high grade op amp. Zero output impedance, so we can see act as perfect internal voltage source, no internal resistance. Output impedance in series with load, we can see this is the voltage source, this is the Rout, which is at series with the load resistance. output impedance in series with load, reducing output voltage to the load. Practically, output resistance is 10 to 100 ohm in this range, and we can see if this is the loop, our voltage is V naught bar. So this is the voltage source divided by these two resistance. So R load and R out. So voltage divided by these two resistance is the current. This, if we multiply by this R load, so this will be the voltage at output, that is the V load, load voltage. Now frequency gain relation, here frequency we are increasing and this is the gain. Okay, so we can see the graph. When frequency is very low, gain is very high, and as frequency goes high, gain continues to decrease. Ideally, signals are amplified from DC to the highest AC frequency, but practically, bandwidth is limited. 741 family op amp have an limit bandwidth of few kilowatts only. Unity gain frequency F1, the gain at unity. So when we are having gain at 1, so that much we are taking at F1, and cutoff frequency, that is FC, that is the gain drop by 3 decibel from the DC gain GD. So this is DC gain GD. From here, when there is 3 decibel drop, that is 0.707 times of DC gain, so 20 log of this is 3 decibel, so that two point is this point is given by cutoff frequency, this is F1, so this is the range. Now GV product, that is F1, that is equal to GD into FC. So this is the formula. Now we are having one example also. Determine the cutoff frequency of an op amp having an unit gain frequency F1 10 MHz and the voltage difference in gain GD equal to 20 volt per millivolt. So this point is given, this point we have to determine. Now as F1 is equal to 10 MHz, by using GV production equation, this formula we are using. So F1 equal to GD FC, so FC will be F1 by GD, so we just take division and it is 500 Hz, that is the cutoff frequency. Now ideal versus practical op amp, open loop gain A, ideally it is infinity, practically it is 10 to 5, bandwidth also ideally it is infinity, but practically it is 10 to 100 Hz, input impedance ideally it is infinity, practically it is greater than 1 mega ohm, output impedance ideally it is 0, practically it is 10 to 100 ohm. Output voltage ideally it is depends only on VD, that is the difference between two input terminal differential mode signal, but practically depends slightly on average input, that is common mode signal. CMRR ideally it is infinity, but practically it is 10 to 100 decibel. This we can see the ideal and practical op amp is given. Ideally, these two input is separated and this is Vin into A, so this the difference is Vin into A, the gain, and it is open loop gain, so that much voltage we are having here, and Z down equal to 0, this is ideally, but practically we have some difference. There is one resistance between these two terminal, and this is AV in, but with AV in we have another resistance Z out also connected. This is the difference between ideal and practical op amp. Now ideal op amp application we are having analysis method, that is two ideal op amp properties, the voltage between non-inverting terminal and inverting terminal is zero when both the voltage applied is zero, it is equal, then the difference is zero. The current in both the terminals is zero, this is ideally. And for ideal op amp circuit we do at the Kirchhoff off mode equation at the non inverting terminal V plus, next we write the Kirchhoff off mode equation at the inverting terminal, that is V minus, and we take equal, both them we take as equal and solve the desired closed loop gain. So these two equations we make it, and we form these two equations we solve for closed loop gain. Next it is non-inverting amplifier. So non-inverting, so we give our input voltage to non-inverting, that is positive terminal only. Kirchhoff's node equation at V plus yields V plus equal to VI. Kirchhoff node equation at V minus yield. Now we can see this terminal is connected to ground via RF. RF is the resistance between inverting terminal and output. So we can see V minus minus 0 divided by RF, V minus minus 0 divided by RF. So this current and V minus minus V 0 by RF, V minus minus V 0 divided by RF. So this is the this terminal, this resistance current, both we are adding, and addition of them is equal to 0. Now both we are taking, and finally it is VI by RA plus Vi minus V0 by Rf equal to 0 or V0 by Vi equal to 1 plus Rf by Ra. So non-inverting amplifier output is 1 plus Rf by Ra multiplied by Vi. Next is non-inverting input with voltage divider. So we can see this terminal is same, but here two resistance is given. So here Vo will be equal to 1 plus Rf by Ra. This term is as it is. One another term will be there, R2 by R1 plus R2 into Vi. Next, voltage follower. Output voltage will equal to input voltage. This is called voltage follower. That is, output terminal is connected to input terminal by resistance. And less than unity gain, in this case output voltage equal to, for this circuit, R2 by R1 plus R2 into Vi, that is input voltage. Inverting amplifier, we can see Kirchhoff's node induction at V plus, this adds V plus equal to 0. At V minus terminal, inverting terminal, it adds V in minus V. V minus V minus, actually there is a negative terminal voltage divided by Rn, this is the current, plus Vo minus V minus divided by Rf, this current equal to 0. Setting V plus equal to V minus years, V0 by V in equal to minus Rf by Rf. Here we have a note, the closed loop gain Vo by Vin is dependent upon the ratio of two resistors and is independent of the open loop gain. I repeat once again, the closed loop gain Vo by Vin is dependent upon the ratio of two resistors and is independent of the open loop gain. This is caused by the use of feedback output voltage to subtract from the input voltage. Multiple inputs, that is different inputs are given to different resistances. Kirchhoff's node equation at non-inverting terminal, that is 0 because it is connected to ground. Kirchhoff's node equation at inverting terminal, it adds V minus minus Vo divided by Rf, that is current at this branch, plus V minus minus Va by Rf, current at this branch, plus current at this branch, plus current at this branch equal to 0. And we take V plus equal to V minus, and finally if we solve, we are having Vo equal to minus Rf multiplied by Va by Rl plus V by Rb plus Vc by Rc, that is equal to minus Rf summation J equal to A to C. So how much resistance, that is how much path we can give, it will be Vj by Rj. This equation will determine the output voltage. Now inverting integrator we do it by giving one input voltage and impedance to inverting terminal and a impedance to input to output and non-inverting terminal to ground. Now replace resistor RA and RF by complex component ZA and ZF respectively. Therefore, VO equal to minus ZF by ZA into Vin. This we are supposing. Next, number one, the feedback component is a capacitor C, that is ZF is equal to Z omega C. Now this is overlap, it is Z omega C. The input component is a resistor R. Z equal to R, therefore the closed loop gain VO by V become V of T equal to minus 1 by RC integration VIT of DT. This is equal to VIT equal to VI e to the power j omega t, and this is one if we are taking Z A equal to this one question. If we take Z A equal to 1 by j omega c and Z F equal to R, so we are having inverting differentiator. Now op amp integrator is one example. This is the case of input voltage VI. For 100 microsecond it is 5 volt. Now we have to determine wherever C is 0.01 microfarad. Okay, so the question is determine the rate of change of the output voltage and draw the output waveform. Now the solution is rate of change of the output voltage, that is delta VO by delta T equal to minus VI by RC. We just put the values, that is 5 volt divided by 10 kilo ohm into 0.01 microfarad. It will be equal to minus 50 millivolt per microsecond. So this is the rate of change of the output voltage, and for output waveform in 100 microsecond output voltage decrease, that is rate into time, so minus 5 volt. So that means if it is starting with 0, whenever this is given it goes to minus 5 volt. Again it is going same, again this it is going to minus 10 volt. This is the waveform. So in today's lecture we have seen some of the important characteristics of op amp, and we have seen how op amp is working for different kind of circuits. Next we will continue. Thank you.